Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular 0 to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about routing in Angular. And in this video, I'm going to explain about forms in Angular. To be more specific, I'm going to explain about template-driven forms. Forms in general are used to collect data from users. Some applications use forms to enable users to log in, to register, to update a profile and more. Angular supports two types of forms. They are template-driven forms and model-driven forms, also known as reactive forms. Template-driven approach is the easiest way to build the Angular forms. The logic of the form is placed in the template itself. But in reactive forms, the logic of the form is defined in the component as an object. Compared to template-driven forms, they are more robust, scalable, reusable and testable. So template-driven forms are suitable for small or simple forms, while reactive forms are more scalable and suitable for complex forms. Using a simple example, let us see how we can create and use both template-driven and reactive forms. I have created this application. Here I have two links, template-driven approach and model-driven approach. And when I click the first link, I'm showing a page in which I have a template-driven form, and when I click the second link, I'll be taken to another page with a reactive form. If you're not sure how I achieved this, you can refer the previous topic in this series, which is routing in Angular. And in template-driven page HTML, you can see I have used just a HTML form using Bootstrap framework. I have three form groups and a button to submit it. Here I have to tell about two things. First, you can see I have removed the action and method from the form. And also, I have used the button type as button, not submit, because I don't want the form to be submitted on its own. Instead, I want Angular to process the form through HTTP module. And for now, there is no big difference between the code in template-driven and model-driven approach. Only difference is this title. Okay, let's get into action. We have already learned about template reference variable. Let me add a template reference variable. Let me also add a click event to the button and pass this reference variable to component through the function. And I'm printing that reference variable. Now if you see, when I click the button, we can see only the DOM elements related to the form. In Angular, we can bind this template reference variable to a directive called ngForm. But when I add this, we can see this error. No directive found with export as ngForm. This is because when we use ngForm, it is important we need to import the forms module. So when I import, the error is gone. But I want to show you something. So let me remove the ngForm binding for a minute. Previously, we have seen when I click the button, it was just printing the DOM elements related to the form. There was nothing extra. But now, after importing the forms module, if I click the button, we can see few more Angular related classes are also added to the form. This is because when we add forms module, Angular infers this form tag and dynamically add these classes. We are also going to see the use of these classes soon. Okay, let me bind it with ngForm again. Now if I click, we can see it is not printing the DOM elements. Instead, we are getting an ngForm object. Let me expand the form property. And we can see this object has lot of properties. All those are useful in form handling. We are going to see it soon. Also, we can see there is a property called controls. But it is an empty object. That is because we have only binded the form with ngForm. And so Angular can recognize this as a form, but it does not know what are the form controls it needs to consider. For that, we can use another directive, ngModel, which we can use to bind it to the controls, like this. But one thing we need to note here is, when we use ngModel, we need to specify the name attribute also. Otherwise, it will give us this error. So after I bind this, we can see now the form controls also registered. Each control in turn have many useful properties. One of them is value. So if I type something in the form and click the button, we can see the values too. In the beginning, I was telling that I changed the button type to button instead of submit. And I also added a click event to call the onSubmit function. But the better place to call this onSubmit function is different. We have a directive ngSubmit, which we can use to bind it to the onSubmit function. And so let me remove the click event from the button. Change the button type back to submit. And in the form, let me use event binding to bind the ngSubmit to onSubmit function. Now also we can see this is working. Let's move to form validation. If you see here, when I submit, we can see the status property in the form is showing as valid, because we haven't added any validation and so the form is valid by default. Let me add a required field validation in both username and email fields. For that, I can use the HTML attribute required. When I add this, Angular understands that these fields are required for the form. So if I submit this time, we can see the status is invalid. We can also check this in field level. We can see username is invalid, email is invalid, and returns is valid. But as we have some invalid fields, the overall form itself is showing as invalid. And when I add some text in the required fields and submit, we can see the form is valid again. Similarly, for the email field, let me add one more validation for email syntax. Again, I can use the email attribute here. Now, if I submit it, we can see the form is invalid again because we haven't entered a valid email format. Let me correct that. Now, if I submit, the form is valid again. So let's use this feature to disable our button when the form is invalid and allow the user to submit only after valid inputs. So I am adding a disabled property and binding it against form status like this. Now only when my form is valid, I can submit it. Let's improve this further. Now as the form is having only three fields, we can easily identify which field is invalid. But in bigger forms, with many fields, it will be difficult for the user to identify. So let's highlight the fields those are invalid. For that, we can make use of the dynamic classes added by Angular. Let me show that. When the form is first loaded, if I inspect the username field, we can see there is a class NGINVALID. But when I enter some text, this becomes NGVALID. So we can make use of this class. Let me add a CSS to add a border color for this class. If you see, now the entire form is highlighted because we can see the same class is added to the form as well. So let's tweak the CSS to highlight only the input fields. Okay, now it is better. Again, the highlight field is showing always even when the form is loading. This is not good. Let's go back and inspect it again. We can also see another class NGUNTOUCHED. When I click inside the field and clicking outside, we can see this class is getting changed to ngTouched. So we can make use of this class too. Let me change the CSS. Now if I click inside and clicking outside, this is getting highlighted. This is good. Let's also see the third dynamic class which is getting added. That is ngPristine. So when I click inside and clicking outside, we can see still it is pristine. But when I start changing some value, we can see this class is changed to ngDirty. Even after reverting my change, it is going to be dirty. So if our requirement is like, we need to highlight the field only if the user changes the existing value, we can use this ngDirty class instead of ngTouched. Now we are informing the user there is a problem in the field. Let's also enhance our form by adding some custom error messages. Let me add one for username. We need to display this to the user when there is an error. As the username field is having only one validation, we can directly check the state of the field to show the error message. To access the field, we can bind it to ngModel, like how we bind the form to ngForm. Now we can use an ngif to show the error message when the username field is not valid. We can also improve it further by also checking whether the username field is touched. So initially it will not show the error message, but when I touch this and click outside without entering anything, it will display the error message. For username field, this is good because we have only one validation. But if you see in the email field, we have two validations. So it should be good if we can show a specific error message. How can we do that? Let me remove this code for a while so that I can show you something. Let me submit it without any values. Now in the email field inside errors object, we can see required true. When I enter something and submit, we can now see the errors object is having email true. And when I enter a valid email, this becomes null. So we can make use of this to show the custom error messages. First, let me get access to the email field using ngModel. And then I'm going to check first whether there is an error. And then let me check whether the type of the error is required. And finally, I'm also checking whether the field is touched. Similarly, let me also do the same for checking error type email. Now it is working as expected. Let's see how we can reset the form. Actually, we can have another button for resetting the form and directly call the form.reset in template. But now we can access the form using view child and reset it in the component like this. So after I submit the form, all the field values are cleared. Also, if you like to default some value in the form, we can use property binding to bind the ngModel. If I want to default this checkbox, I can bind the ngModel to true. And if I want to default the name, I can bind the ngModel to a text value. So note, I need to use quotes here. This is all about template driven forms. Next, I'm going to explain about reactive forms or model driven forms. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.